Welcome to Solo Travel POV, and welcome to Washington, D.C. We're here today on America's National Mall at the Fleet of the Future Expo presented by Metro. We'll see what they have in store for the future of Metro cars and innovations they're making for transportation in America going forward. The last time something like this was implemented was in 1979, when President Lyndon B. Johnson viewed a future Metro car on the front lawn of the White House. Let's go. And here it is, the new 8000 series train to be manufactured by Hitachi. I love the contextual artwork that they have around this exhibit too. You can see the 1960 proposed Metro rail design and compare it directly with what it's going to look like in 2027. I also love this pennant here of the grand opening of the Metro and wish that I could snag one of those for myself. Here's the front of the train where the conductor sits. I do love the sleek design of this train. I like the lights that they've implemented on this. We do have to note that they're going away from the previous brown theming of Metro trains and using the silver theming that is on the existing 7000 series. There's some cool retro artwork throughout here, some history about the Metro, and walking up to this, it's almost like a mini Metro museum surrounded by all the wonderful Smithsonian museums on the National Mall. They are giving out some Hitachi pens, Hitachi bags, Hitachi being the new manufacturer for this train, and there's also some pamphlets and little cardboard train models that you can construct. On the pamphlets, they let you know the new features of the train, which I will be putting up on the screen now for you to read. And as we walk through the 8000 series car here, we'll be showing off each of those new features as they've shown on the demo model here. Walking up and walking beside the train to board it, it feels largely the same. Not too much has changed from the actual bones of the train, so the general layout is very similar to the previous models. The main thing that you'll notice here, of course, is the connected gangways between the two trains, meaning that essentially each train set now has two cars that are interconnected. And compare this to the 6000 series train, where I walked in on the end of it at the clip that you'll see here, but it's a much shorter connection. I do love this mock-up of the new Metro map. You can see here that any stations that we've already passed are grayed out along the silver line, and it also lets us know the upcoming stops and the final stop of where the train will be terminating. This is a great mock-up, and I hope they do implement this on the future trains. Throughout the demo, they also have some other screens placed on the train. These screens are implemented on the 7000 series trains, but to a lesser extent, they're used for advertisements. Sometimes they're used for just general Metro messages. There's also another information screen that's a smaller version of the map that we saw earlier. I imagine that breaking news section would also hold some advertisements in the future for Metro. Here's another mock-up of the future station arrivals. This is also implemented on the 7000 series train. I will show a clip of that now, how it looks currently. On the mock-up, they said that we will be arriving at Federal Triangle, but everywhere else on the train, it says that we are accurately at the Smithsonian Station. And another feature mentioned was the security cameras. I actually had to ask an employee about this one after reading it on the pamphlet, but they did have the attention to detail to place some stickers on the ceilings of where future security cameras may be placed on the train. The employee also let me know that something which was not mentioned on the pamphlet was the future implementation of some outlets and charging stations for people to use. So back there was an example of where a charging station could be placed. And coming up here, where it shows the National Mall, this is another place where a charging station could be. Walking through here, we can see the open gangway implementation. A lot of the features on this train, honestly, have been implemented of transit systems throughout the world, so I essentially see this as Metro catching up and modernizing the fleet the best they can. As people walked in, so many of them mentioned the lack of cushions on the train, but do note that the actual trains will have cushions, and there's a model of what that will feel like on the outside. Here's a nice shot from the back of the train. You can see the beautiful museums around the National Mall. And here's a luggage rack that you can use to add your luggage. Hopefully it doesn't slide down though. Here's a direct comparison shot of the Kawasaki 7000 series and the Hitachi 8000 series. You'll notice there's some dots along the floor. Maybe that's meant to signify the heating elements of the train. Though I'm not sure I've ever felt cold on a metro train before, but I will be excited to try out that feature during the winter months. But honestly, if someone were to spill some soda or put chicken wings on the floor of the metro, I'm not sure if I want to smell that heated up trash for the duration of my ride. We'll see how that turns out for metro. The three seating is a new feature of the train and reminded many people as they walked in of the New York subway or also the Tokyo metro system. I personally would not sit in one of these seats just because I enjoy my personal space. And you can also see that the railings at the top here go much lower than the previous models. This here is the seat where I normally sit when I get on the metro. I thought it might be a little bit smaller than the current trains, but it was still comfortable for my needs. And of course, being in Washington, D.C., we have to add some cherry blossom flair to the train, so they did a nice job of that here, and I'm sure all the tourists appreciate that as they're taking a break from seeing the cherry blossoms. I've never sat in a conductor's seat before, so this was very interesting to me. One of the employees let me know that the big screen here is used to notify the conductors if there's any issues with the train. And they did have enough attention to detail here to actually show a heating dial for the heated seats going forward. Other features not mentioned on the train are connected Wi-Fi. Personally, my phone is always very well connected when I'm on the metro, but perhaps some tourists will appreciate it. That being said though, I do know that many people who come to visit America are buying SIMs. They have a phone plan that lets them roam freely at a very cheap cost, so perhaps this Wi-Fi is a feature that's too little too late now at this point. Alright, this is the most important feature. This is the feature that all passengers use the most, the seats. I thought this seat was very comfortable, more comfortable than any of the seats on the 3000 or 7000 series trains currently. The cushion was great, it had great back support. Again, this is what everyone's going to use, so I'm very glad they included this and it was a great addition for the mock-up and implementation of the 8000 series train. Finally, walking through, they have a feedback survey for everyone to fill out. So this is a great way for people to add their own feedback and let Metro know what they appreciated about the new trains. I'm sure all these features will make it into the 8000 series, but maybe they could have a staggered release on some things like the information screens, depending on some of the feedback from the passengers here. I did love the trains, and I think that overall, having more cars in the fleet will lead to better wait times on the platform. So by all means, you know, go ahead, go forward with these 8000s and let's get them running. Also seen here is a bus mock-up for an information screen. It shows you where the next stops are, breaking news, and also amenities available at each station. There is a piece of metal here. I'm not exactly sure what that is. You guys can let me know in the comments. And here's a mock-up of the metro flooring that will be implemented by Baltar Flooring Solutions. Thank you all so much for watching. A shorter video today by normal solo travel POV standards, but I appreciate the subscriptions, comments, and likes. And remember, if Lyndon B. Johnson can take metro, then so can you. Take care.